Hindu Marriage Act 1955. The governing of all marriages of the Hindu religion in India is done under the Hindu Marriage Act 1955. Every aspect of a marriage, including husband, wife, marriage, commitment, sex, and child rearing, are covered under this act. As in India, each citizen is allowed to be dealt under personal laws relevant to religious views. Hence, the Hindu Marriage Act was enacted by Parliament in 1955 to codify marriage law between Hindus as part of the Hindu Code Bill. The guideline under the Act. It provides guidelines for Hindus to be in a systematic marriage bond and applies to all forms of Hinduism, and also recognizes offshoots of the Hindu religion as specified in the Article 44 of the Indian Constitution. Notably, these include Jains and Buddhists. The Act also applies to anyone who is a permanent resident in India, who is not Christian, Jew, Parsi or Muslim or bi-religion. The Anandkarj Marriage Act provides Sikhs their own personal law related to marriage. Marriage is an official name given to the relationship of two individuals in which they promise each other to spend the rest of their life with love and affection. It is a bond of understanding, trust and care among the two souls. Still, misunderstandings arise at time to time, and if not dealt nicely, can even reach a stage of divorce. Aspects covered by the Act. The Hindu Marriage Act set out every condition regarding marriage by a Hindu couple, and these are quoted in the Section 5 of the Hindu Marriage Act. It explains the conditions under which a marriage is void. For example, age of the groom and bride. A marriage may be later be annulled in following conditions, including if the bride or groom is impotent or not able to consummate the marriage and unfit for the procreation of children. The Hindu Marriage Act further deals with every topic related to marriage, including registering a marriage, ceremonies, divorce, and grounds for divorce, alimonies, and remarriage. The Act and Married Couple. The Hindu Marriage Act protects rights of both the husband and wife. Further, the Act ensures ample chance for intimacy to be grown between the concerned couple. The importance of sex in marriage is to cultivating a flourishing relationship, and this is how the relationship of the couple is protected. Even if the relation between couples becomes strained at certain times and come to a breaking point, the Act caters for mending of relationship before final divorce stage is reached. There are several clauses providing ample chance for a healthy and long married life of a couple. The commitment cannot be a single-minded decision. With one partner issuing all the rules and conformities, it has to be a mutual agreement of needs and requirements in a future you want to share together, with commitment levels you present to each other, open to compromise and discussion. Preconceived ideas or fears about commitment are essentially preparing you to understanding the difference between promise and commitment. Sometimes, couples know something is off, but they put off dealing with it until the problem becomes too big to ignore.